Evening everyone. Today we are going to look at drug-modified tinea. Tinea, we all know, is a fungal infection caused by dermatophytosis, and drug-modified tinea refers to tinea over which a steroid is being applied. And topical corticosteroid therapy started in 1951 when Sulzberger and Witten introduced hydrocortisone in the market. And it took off, to use the current terminology, it took off like the current terminology we use is viral, it spread viral. And so much so that within 20 years, a new disease, drug-modified tinea or tinea incognito, was added to the list of diseases. And I'm sure none of us here can practice without using a steroid in our day-to-day practice. This drug-modified tinea was given by Ivan Marks in the year 1968, and that time only a topical steroid was being used in the market. And currently, we have what is called as non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs like tacrolimus and pimecrolimus, which can also cause drug-modified tinea. And this has got an interesting Indian connection because Siddhaya, an Indian, was the one who discovered this drug-modified tinea caused by non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs. In India, we have drug-modified tinea primarily due to steroid, because gram for gram, the non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs cost 3 times as much as a steroid, and most of these steroids being applied on a fungus or the OTC preparations given by the friendly neighborhood chemist or by patients who prescribe for one another. Now, what happens when we apply a steroid on a tinea? The margins get diminished, the scaling is lost, and erythema is reduced. I'm going to show you pictures of a few drug-modified tinea. These were seen in my clinic the last 3 weeks. This is a lady with a huge patch of tinea on the forearm. You can see that there's hardly any redness. Scaling is there, but the margins are not too clear. And as one keeps applying as one keeps applying the steroid, this is what happens. You can see the margins become indistinct. Some of the redness remains, and some scaling is there. And this is a lesion in the dorsum of the right foot. We can see the margins are there. Erythema is a little bit there. And this is a so-called endpoint. We hardly get to see any redness, and no erythema is there, and indistinct margins are there. You'll also notice that all these 4 sites are rather unusual locations for tinea. We normally expect to see tinea in the groin, the axilla, and the waist in women when they wear tight garments. But these are all locations like the elbow, the dorsum of the foot, and the ankle. They are not very common sites. And when we get to see tinea in these sites, we always think of drug-modified tinea. Rarely get what is called the concentric rings of enlargement. We can see one ring here and another ring inside. And this again, you will notice that it is in the nape of the neck as well as the upper shoulder. Again, sites which are not usually associated with tinea. Having diagnosed a drug-induced tinea, what do we do? First, stop the drug which has steroid. Number two is start antifungal therapy. Here, the rules of two apply. Two into two into two into two. Number one, use two types of antifungals. One topical, the other is oral. And suppose you use something like an alalamine orally, like terbinafine. Topically, we don't use the same drug. We use something like ketoconazole or fluconazole or clotrimazole. That's the azole type. Number two is apply the drug twice a day topically. Number three is keep applying till clinical improvement is there, and don't stop with it. Do it 2 weeks after the lesions have completely cleared. Number four is apply not only on the lesion, but also in a 2 centimeter margin around the lesion. Then I would like to give you some tips about using antifungal therapy. I'm just going to highlight two side effects. Fluconazole, which is being very commonly used, is contraindicated in pregnant women. Even a single dose of fluconazole can cause abnormalities in the fetus. So if the patient is planning a pregnancy, please do not use fluconazole. Rizafulmin has got two interesting side effects. Men who are on rizafulmin should not father a child for the next 6 months because it can cause abnormalities in the sperm. And rizafulmin has also got a side effect when women who are on oral contraceptives take rizafulmin. It interacts with the oral contraceptives, makes it less effective, and so pregnancies can occur and can also cause breakthrough bleeding. Thank you very much.
What is the current role of Whitfield ointment in the treatment of fungus?
Sir, like all olden drugs, it is taking a comeback, sir. And because it is more the keratolytic action of the salicylic acid that is being used for as topical antifungal therapy. And in fact, there is a new product called New Whitfield, which has the old Whitfield and with an Indian new name.
In the former literature of Cantiforce, itraconazole, the duration of treatment for various fungus infections has been very widely different. Why is it so? The one length for tinea in the body, one length for the tinea in the prurience, one length for tinea. If you have gone through the literature.
Yes, I have.
Fine.
So it all depends on the rate of cell mitosis, sir.
No, no, I can understand nail fungus as a differential tank.
Yes, sir.
Why is the differential tank, the say, anterior chest, vis-a-vis the groin, vis-a-vis the back tank?
Sir, it's the treatment is for 4 weeks for the tinea cruris. It is the lesion in the groin, lesion in the back, or lesion in the waist in women. And the lesion in the chest usually are single. So we do not give a long-term antifungal therapy. And for single lesions, oral antifungals, or especially itraconazole is better avoided in my opinion, because itraconazole is sort of the ultimate. And if indiscriminate use of itraconazole is there, then we don't have anything to fall back on.
Is there any benefit of combining one group with another group? For example, salicylic acid, benzoic acid, pitavastatin.
Yes, sir. There is. The benefit is that suppose the fungus that is present in this patient's body is resistant to one type of antifungal, the other type of antifungal can act. That's why I said that when we have treat drug modified tinea, we use two different types. Like you have to take orally either fluconazole or itraconazole, and then topically use a different kind of antifungal like alalamine, like terbinafine.
Thank you, sir. I now welcome Professor Dev Naidu to give a certificate of appreciation.
Thank you.
Ask for
now. Oh, okay, sir.
Sir, you have to write up.